Hey guys, in this new video, we're going to take a look at the different types of equilibrium constants. Now, one thing we're going to realize by going through chemistry 1 and chemistry 2 is that K is a very, very popular variable. We have it everywhere. We have our rate constant K. We have actually a K for acids and bases. We call them Ka and Kb. Ka is called our acid dissociation constant, whereas Kb is called our base dissociation constant. Now we're talking about different types of equilibrium constants. So K is really, really popular in when it comes to calculations in chemistry. Now, we've talked about the equilibrium constant up to this point. We've said that it's equal to products over reactants. And we should realize is that we have different types of equilibrium constants based on the units that we're using. Now we're gonna say when dealing with gases, we usually use the equilibrium constant Kp. And we're going to say Kp uses the partial pressure unit of atmospheres. And we're going to say when dealing with aqueous solutes, remember, aqueous means that water is dissolving my compound. So when we're using aqueous solutes, we tend to use the equilibrium constant Kc. Now Kc uses the concentration unit of molarity. And remember, molarity is moles over liters. And also remember, molarity is the same thing as concentration and the same thing as solubility. So we've seen that we have Kp and Kc now. And we're going to say that these two are related together by this equation. Kp equals Kc RT to the delta N. Here we're going to say that R is called our gas constant. And it equals 0.08206 liters times atmospheres over moles times K. Now remember, there's another R variable out there. It's 8.314 joules over moles times K. But we only use that one when we're dealing with energy, velocity, or speed. In this case, we're not dealing with energy, velocity, or speed. We're dealing with equilibrium concentrations. So that's why we're using this particular R. We're going to say that T represents our temperature in Kelvin. And then we're going to say, most importantly, is our delta N exponent. Delta N equals moles of gas as products minus moles of gas, again, remember gas, as reactants. So we started out with the broad idea of an equilibrium constant K, but now we've delved in deeper to Kp and Kc.